It's your boy Charlie Sloth. You're now locked onto the Unsigned Zone, and this is my industry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. For those that don't know, I'm a guy who came up through the game as an artist, became an online media mogul, created my own online show, which is still to this day the most viewed hip-hop show in the world. Was getting like over 1 million views a week, and now I've got the biggest rap show in Europe. The 5 steps that I'd give to unsigned artists that are trying to do their thing and really get on in the game, I would say the first step is making that decision whether you're serious and you want to make this a full-time job and a business, or whether it's a hobby. I think it's really important to separate the two. If you're serious, you've got to give it 100%, and that means sacrifices. That means like not being able to have a job where it's career driven and, you know, like you've got goals to meet within that job, because your music or whatever you're trying to achieve is gonna take the hit for that. And obviously everyone has to eat and everyone has to bring money in, but like again, what I was saying before, it comes down to sacrifices. What sacrifices you're prepared to make to get where you want to be. The second step is making sure you're consistent. Consistency is the most important thing. For me, looking for hot artists that I want to support on my show and for people that I want to bring up and really push, one of the main things I look for is consistency. You could be the hottest rapper out there, you can have the most crazy bars, but if you're not consistent, people ain't fucking with you, man. And it's not just me that ain't gonna be fucking with you, it's the audience that don't really want to be like tapping into something that they've got to wait for 3 months for something else to come out. So when I say be consistent, like, I mean, like, Sneak Boy is a great example, right? Like, Sneak Boy has got crazy heat out there right now. And Sneak Boy's key to his success for me was his consistency. I was going online maybe every other day and it felt like I was seeing a new video from this guy. A new track and a new video. I was like, raw. Now, they weren't the craziest quality. You know what I'm saying? It was obviously made by him and his people. But it's the fact that he was out there actively doing that, putting the work in and making sure that he was in people's faces. So he was consistent, and therefore he got in people's faces and he got in my face. So my second point for you really getting on this game is remain consistent. Don't think by putting out one hot track every 2 months is enough for you to get a buzz and get on. Once a month, a new track, new video, even more regular than that. Like, if you can, I would say every 2 weeks. If you're not signed, there's nothing holding you back. Especially if you're not selling that music, especially if it's a bootleg or you're just like doing a remix. There's no reason for you not to be up in people's faces. So number two is consistency. Number three for me is building a team. Now, this for me is probably one of the most important parts of it. Like, you need a good team around you, people whose opinion you can value and trust. There's nothing worse than being surrounded by people that only say yes. So like, if you make a hot track and you want an opinion on it, don't ask your friends. Don't ask people around you that you know are gonna say, yeah, that's hot fam, that's our big track, you know, Beijing. Don't do it. Send it to people whose opinion you value and trust. Find, what I used to do is, I made a network of connectors. People that I met when I was out in the scene. People who were doing things in the game. And I made a list of five connectors whose opinion I valued. So what I would do is every time I made something new, whether it be a video or a song, I would send it to these five people who I knew would just give it to me exactly how it was. No bullshit, not wrapped up all nice. They would just tell me exactly what it is. And I knew from there, I could value what they were saying to me and I could make changes on the basis of what they said to me. And it's always good to find people, five different people from five different walks of life. So you know you're tapping into different parts of the audience, you know what I'm saying? Find a good manager, someone who you can trust. So important. You need a manager who you can trust and rely on to make good decisions for you, because judgment is so important. Find a good press officer, a PR company. They're there. Some people will, you know, if they believe in you and they think you've got something going on, they might work for you for free on a building agreement where you get signed, you use them later on in your career or whatever the case may be. Find a radio plugger. Find someone who you know has got access to the DJs. You know, it's like everything's there, you just gotta find it. And Google and word of mouth, like, it's not hard to find these people. Number four, if you're really trying to get on this game and you're really, really, you know, passionate about making it, judgment. When I say making good judgment calls, what I mean is, like, if you have a video and the video you think it's all right, it's decent, but you think it could be damaging in any way, like through things you're talking about or stuff that's in the video, then it's a good idea to get a second opinion. Because if your judgment's wrong on that video and you decide to put that video out and it backfires on you, just an example, like someone like myself, if you send me a video, right, so if you've made a video and other people around you are like, it's all right, I'm not sure. So if you've gone to your connectors and they're like, you can do better, you could do better, and then you send that video to me and I watch that video and I think the video is trash and I think you're chatting garbage and I think like the visuals that you're trying to portray are a madness, it's going to be very, very, very hard to me to watch your second video. So make sure your judgment's good. And it comes back to number three, having a team or connectors around you who you can trust to send your material out there to before you put it in the public domain. Because once it's out there, it's out there. It's no turning back. Before, like, if especially if it's controversial, like, OG Nikki's a great case study for that. Like, as soon as that video was out there, like, even if she wanted to take it down and she wanted to retract that statement, which she didn't because she done very well off the back of it. But if she wanted to, there would have been no chance of her doing that because so many people have ripped that and copied the video and it's there. Like, it's not going away. So you can't retract that statement. You're in that pigeonhole. And if you don't know that pigeonhole, your judgment should have been better. Now, number five, one of the most important things in being an artist and distinguishing yourself as an artist in today's urban, rap, grime, whatever you want to call it, scene, right? I mean, just in general. I'm not even trying to put it into genres. Just in general, just distinguishing yourself as an artist. Know your audience. Know who you're trying to sell to. Know who you're trying to reach, man. Like, for me, like, if you're an artist and you don't really know who you're trying to sell to, or you don't know who your audience are, you're lost. Yeah, it's like, before the battle's begun, you've lost. It's uphill. You might get there, but it's gonna take a long time if you don't know who you're trying to push that music to. So, for an example, like, if you're making hip-hop and you're trying to push that to jungle fans, it's dead. Like, they're gonna be like, what's this shit? I ain't looking to listen to this shit. Like, you gotta know who you're, like, pushing your music to. Like, it's these days it's more than music, it's a lifestyle. Like K-Coke's music's incredible, but not only is he selling his music, he's selling a lifestyle. So he's selling a lifestyle to an audience, and he knows who his audience are. His audience are the streets, people from the streets, people from an unprivileged background, where obviously he knows that his experiences in life can tap into that market. So what he's done is he's packaged up his lifestyle, the life he's lived, and he's sold you his lifestyle. And that is knowing your audience. If you don't know your audience, you know what? Look at yourself, find out who you're trying to appeal to, what are you trying to say in your records, and take some step back and kind of, you know, evaluate your situation. If you don't know your audience, it's an uphill struggle. So number five, know your audience.